so I'm the Minister of Planning of Morocco, so I would like first to extend his apologies for not being able to attend this meeting, which is due to extraordinary circumstances. So I'm just going to read his speech, just like, we're not taking like 2 minutes. So I'm
2 minutes, I'll hold you to that.
Oh, okay. Okay, so, thank you, the professor. So I would like first to extend his apologies and allow me first to thank Dr. Landini and Dr. Sabina, as well as all the departments inviting us to attend this high level meeting and for the opportunity they are offering to High Commission of Planning of Morocco, which is responsible of the collection of the data and also development studies, to contribute to this exchange of experiences between institutions and researchers from different continents in charge of socioeconomic studies and statistics on the phenomenon of poverty and its relationship to economic growth and social progress. So we know today how much the conceptual and operational advances on these studies owe to such meetings, to the exchange of knowledge and experiences, and the opportunities of relationships they provide to institutions and researchers who participate in this meeting. Ultimately, it is the dynamic of society that dictates to social welfare economists and statisticians the themes of their research, which contribute to the progress of their methodological approaches and to the object of their discipline. It is what emerges clearly from the experience of our institutions. As in many emerging and developing countries, progress in terms of economic growth and human development made by Morocco have profoundly altered the social context of research and statistical production on the theme of poverty and vulnerability. I confine myself here to give you some indicators that are the origin of this context evolution in Morocco. So we have an annual growth of economic growth of around 5% and over one half of government budget dedicated to social sectors. In addition to the multidimensional and participatory approach of large programs to fight economic, social and cultural determinants of rural and urban poverty, as well as the initiative or a withdrawing project named National Human Development, as our colleague Dr. Mokhtar just talked about. So it is in these circumstances that the MDGs were achieved or in their way to be in Morocco. The index of income poverty at the national level continues to fall and will achieve, according to our work with the World Bank, a level at which it will lose its statistical significance. At the same time, we can see the rise of a subjective poverty that affects beyond poor and vulnerable people, certain social categories among middle income groups. Although the overall level of social inequality has hardly deteriorated, the feeling of being poor is growing in most economically dynamic agglomerations and where inequalities are less dissimulated by traditional social relationships. Furthermore, this social change is generally accompanied by the emergence in our society of new material and cultural needs and provides, in the expression of these needs, a growing weight of new civil society actors, especially among young people and women. Indicators such as access to water, electricity, and universal primary schooling now almost equally or now almost equally or partially are losing their place among the factors referred to in the measurement of poverty to new indicators. So in the light of these evolutions, we have started since 2008, in addition to the monetary income approach, to bring a multidimensional approach to our analysis of the phenomena of poverty, vulnerability, and social inequality, and exploit our surveys in order to quantify these dimensions. So tomorrow we will be talking about our methodological approach about Morocco and what we have done in the research of the multidimensional approach. Thank you.